Revit 2023 enhances the user experience for both Generative Design and Dynamo Player. Enjoy added flexibility with new input types, better clarity in method naming, and more consistency across user interfaces. The Define Study dialog supports several new input types for Generative Design. You can now enter number inputs. You can also use a slider with a number entry. Use the slider or enter the design number in the entry box. Use the up and down arrows to increase or decrease the value according to the defined increment. You can browse and select a directory path or a file path as an input in the study dialog. There's no need to define it in the Dynamo script. A stream box can also be used for entering text inputs. And a true-false toggle is now available for Boolean inputs. The Define Study dialog provides new descriptions and thumbnails in the method drop-down to help you choose the proper method for your study. The cross-product method has been renamed Space Evenly to represent better how input is combined with every parameter in a study. The Dynamo Player user interface has been made consistent with the generative design in Revit UI, making the use of both tools more intuitive. Use the Dynamo Player to automate tasks in Revit, and use generative design to explore multiple solutions to a design problem. You can now retrieve and expand the support menu using the Help button in the upper right corner of each dialog, and get access to context-sensitive support links in the details of each study or script. Use Dynamo to customize your script descriptions and include hyperlinks for a greater user experience. Achieve better design outcomes more efficiently with these enhancements to Generative Design and Dynamo Player in Revit 2023.